Vietnamese favorite, stuffed squid.
So we basically, we're going to use all of it. This is the little
beak?
Beaks right here. Vietnamese loves it.
It's a tooth.
It's a tooth. The outside of it, it's like the membrane to hold the tooth together, so it's crunchy.
Oh, nice. Okay.
The Vietnamese love textiles.
In English, it's like eating a gum.
There we go.
Yeah, nice. So from snake bones to gums, yeah?
Oh, holy moly. Squid shooting, man. According to European, they usually eat that ink, you know? Make a black spaghetti or something like that.
Do you use it here?
No, not yet.
Wow, that's fantastic news.
Don't give them my idea.
That's the first time in Vietnam, okay? I found something you don't eat. Squid ink.
I found something the Brits eat that the Vietnamese don't. But for me, this complex squid dish beats our deep-fried version any day.
50-50, yeah? Tentacles chopped up and 50% of the pork.
Right.
A little bit of garlic.
Yep.
And a little bit of ginger as well.
We're going to stuff the squid. And a little bit of fish sauce.
I'm amazed you put fish sauce in there.
Well, I mean, if you don't cook fish sauce in Vietnam, then you're some sort of like foreigners here, eh? And drop it in there, please.
And now the base of the sauce is?
Ginger, garlic and onion.
Ginger, garlic and onion.
Yeah.
Nice. They look fantastic.
Nice touch, Gordon.
I've dressed a few squids in my time.
Right.
Haven't fucking caught many. I've dressed a few.
Well, you try hard, sire.
Yeah.
I can't wait to dig in and to see if the sea dogs are as impressed with Duke's dish as I am.
I've got the biggest piece of squid in for you.
There we go. The honor of my man right there.
Cái nhà lá vườn mà chú. Rồi anh em.
How's the squid?
Phù hợp với là khẩu vị của là tất cả anh em mình ngồi đây.
He said it's perfect.
Thank you for being so brilliant and so patient. Amazing.
Không sai không mệt.
It's a pleasure to see you here, and you're not drunk. You're not going home tonight.
Is that the same stuff from his lanterns? No? Here we go. Yeah, Mr. Tech. Congratulations, honestly. Balls of steel.
It's been an amazing day. Getting out to sea and cooking the catch is as simple as it gets. And I've loved getting back to basics.
I didn't grow up with much money around the table. We ate in a very humble way, but here, even if you haven't got much money, you eat in an amazing way, a very fresh way. They don't realize to what a great standard they eat at so cheaply. Tell him I'm a lot better in the kitchen than I am at rowing. Cheers.
Cheers.
Thank
cheers.
You.
I've got one more stop to make before I put my neck on the line to deliver an authentic Vietnamese menu from my culinary mentor, V.
I'm feeling nervous, but exciting, and a week is a very short time to get up to speed with something so magical. But where I connect is with the ingredients, because they're the hero. Understanding them properly will be a huge advantage going into a challenge.
I'm heading off the beaten track into the mountains near Mai Chau, 130 kilometers from Hanoi. This is rice paddy country, and I'm here to get my hands on Vietnam's most important ingredient and to learn the Rolls Royce of rice dishes.
To impress Vietnamese people, one thing you've got to do first off is cook their rice perfectly.
Today the village are celebrating the end of the rice harvest with a feast.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
Good.
Good to see you.
Nice. Sao is the only person in the village who speaks a bit of English.
That was amazing. Honestly, I felt like Steve McQueen. Now, I know I'm a little bit late.
Okay.
And the harvest is finished.
Yes, I'm sorry about
that. But I've just come in time for the feast, right?
Yes.
Look at those little beauties there.
Yes.
Hello.
Hello.
This Northern Hill tribe not only pick the rice, they process it too. But there are no mod cons here.
What's going on there? That is fascinating.
They cut the rice from the field.
They're taking all the little rice grains off the plant, and then it's all swept into the middle of the concrete.
Yeah, can I have a chance?
This is incredible.
Yeah.
Not only that.
Yeah,
I've never been on a bike this long in my life.
You can go to France.
Yeah. I'm sweating like a Vietnamese pig. is what all the ladies do in the morning, the harvest?
Yes. Sometimes the men.
Sometimes the men. Christ, I'm going to look at risottos in a completely different way now. What's the old boy laughing at? Hey, big boy, your turn next.
In this 40 degrees heat, I think I'd better stop before I keel over. Time to put all this rice to good use and learn what they do with it.
And what is this they're making?
Yes, it's made by rice.
So?
This is the rice and it's made with the water.
And so it's pounded rice?
Yes.
Mixed with water?
Yes, but not sticky rice.
No?
Yeah, not sticky.
What is amazing for me is the fact that we cook rice one or two different ways in England. You guys have put a completely different meaning on rice.
Yes.
And she puts onions and pork in the middle.
Pork and the mushroom.
Pork and mushroom. Incredible.
You can try it.
Thank you. Lovely.
For me to make these paper thin rice cakes, I'm going to need to apply a delicate touch.
That's a great start.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. The chair's fucked. Sorry.
How embarrassing. Hopefully I can impress him with my culinary skills.
I've lost half my mix.
Okay. Wait. Oh.
That is what you call sticking to a blanket. Flipping heck. Thank God I didn't grow up in Vietnam. You know, I'd be useless as a chef. Here we go, one more time.
There's a fine art to this, and I just don't have it.
No.
Come in. I'm not going to screw up anymore. Do you know what? I'm in danger of busting this chair. It's starting to collapse again.
No. What
do you think? Delicious.
Delicious.
Very good. I'll buy some new stools.
The entire village have gathered to celebrate the end of the rice harvest.
That looks beautiful.
It is a feast.
That is a proper feast.
My failed attempt at rice cakes won't be on offer. So I helped to serve up instead.
Right, where do we start with this fabulous feast? Look at this. You take the rice and pass it along, right?
And news of my botched rice paper making has obviously done the rounds.
What's your job?
My job? What do you think I do?
You said that you are actor.
Actor?
Yeah.
No.
You are a doctor.
A doctor?
Yeah.
I'm a cook.
We are wrong.
Good luck for next year's harvest. Cheers. Happy harvest.
I have been useless, but Sao has honored my trip with a gift of rice from the village.
Thank you. Wow, look at that. Lovely. That's beautiful. I will do the rice justice, okay? They treat it like gold. They show it so much respect. They have a huge technical ability to make rice so fantastic. It's at a different level.
It's been an amazing week, but tomorrow it's crunch time. I'll be in Hanoi to prove to restaurateur V that I've cracked Vietnamese cuisine.
So lots of things bubbling and festering away now in my mind, and all I need is to disappear somewhere quiet and just start nailing down those issues.
Come to the end of my week in Vietnam, and it's been a culinary trip into the unknown and the unthinkable.
Shit.
My mentor V said 1 week would not be enough to master this cuisine, and I'm about to find out if she was right. I'm in Hanoi to cook a dinner for V and other top tutors I've met this week.
Mr. Rice, how are you, sir?
Oh, yeah.
Good to see you.
How are you doing?
Yeah, well, thank you. This place looks amazing.
Let me show you around here.
Please. It looks beautiful.
Mrs. Duck's friend, Mr. Rice, has given me the use of his fine dining restaurant. Its success is built on authentic Vietnamese cooking, and so it's a great honor.
The restaurant's beautiful.
Yeah, thank you.
Yes. Who designed it?
I designed it myself.
Good job.
Worryingly for me, Mr. Rice has invited along 30 discerning diners.
You're gonna huge, huge challenge. And you know, tonight, so many people here just waiting for your cooking and
I say about 6-7 people, very tough.
Ready.
In 3 hours, the restaurant will be full. And I need to quickly get used to these unfamiliar surroundings.
Wow.
This is the kitchen, yeah?
This is it.
So everything here tonight is yours, yeah? Gas burners and grill.
Completely different layout of a kitchen. It's not like working with a gas ring burner. 10 times more powerful, a lot more instant. So on the fly, yet again.
Tonight, my menu will be drawn on everything I've learned. I'm cooking pig 7 ways.
So starting off with the pork and shrimp, fresh spring roll, yeah?
Yes.
Can we serve at room temperature? Be very careful. Pig's ear salad, blanched in a nice sort of spicy broth. Barbecued pork skewer, and it's grilled over charcoal. Then we're gonna go to the sweet and sour pork ribs. Okay, after that, we've got a pig trotter curry. After that, caramelized pork belly, finished with fish sauce. After that, the pork noodle broth. Let's go. Bye-bye.
My nose-to-tail menu is a tall order. I start with barbecue pork skewers, inspired by Mrs. Duck.
The shoulder of pork, sliced thinly, marinated, and then cooked on charcoal. Now that doesn't look anywhere near like Mrs. Duck's. At times like this, I wish she'd just give me the recipe properly. I think it's secretly because she had a massive crush on me, and she had visions of her and I setting up a restaurant together.
Next for my pig feast, a curry that I hope will satisfy the Vietnamese appetite for texture.
Normally when we use trotters at home in the UK, we bone them out and stuff them, but these are cooked on the bone and very gelatinous. Nice. Fresh turmeric, a little bit of garlic, ginger, fish sauce, and a little bit of fermented rice wine vinegar. Almost like a sort of light, spicy curry.
The pressure is on, and already I've made my first mistake.
So this is my broth. Remember, my singing ordeal down the river. I'm just struggling for that nice sort of lightly sort of pinkish colour.
I'm beginning to wish I'd kept things simple.
I've got one dish seared out of fucking 400 things to do. Fucking hell.
Downstairs, Hanoi's most accomplished foodies have arrived. Along with my mentors, Mrs. Duck and Madam V, all here to pass judgment on my efforts.
I think it's a bit challenging for him because it's something completely new and very different to what you have at home.
B's premonition is coming true. I'm having a kitchen nightmare.
And the broth's gone cloudy, so I turned up the gas, and by rapidly reducing it down for some strength, it's gone cloudy. Here are the sweet and sour ribs. I want to put them in the oven. But they don't have ovens here, so everything's got to be cooked on top. Okay, pork, trotters, broth, ribs.
I think now he's in control. He's in control now. Because it's no shouting, no yelling from the kitchen yet.
Oh, fucking hell. Shit. Bollocks. Shit. They'd kill me if they saw that. Watch out, please, guys. Come on, you go out of the way, please, everybody. Everybody, the spectators.
By now, I should be serving up, but I'm nowhere near ready.
Skewers, please. Okay. Yeah, I need colour on there. I need colour. Come on, please. Yeah, charcoal. That's what gives a colour. Let's go.
It's gone 7:30, and Hanoi's finest have been waiting to eat for over half an hour.
I think in 20 minutes to be here. All the food to be here. I should run up to the kitchen and kick him. Kick his ass.
I'm starving. I need to eat something. Then I'll let you know. I'm waiting for a long time.
Skewers, please. Turn them over. Turn them over. More colour, please. Come on, hero. Yeah?
Finally, my dishes come together.
The broth is nice and clear now. I've clarified it. Some minced pork and an egg white to get it nice and clear.
My homage to Mrs. Duck is almost ready to be served.
Fingers crossed, Madame Duck style. Sesame seed.
And, at the last minute, I've put together my pig's ear salad.
Don't take anything until I say. Don't take anything until they're fucking finished, please. Okay, let's go, please. Gently, 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 gently. No, 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 look, look, no, stop. Yeah, that one goes on there. Right, you come here, stand here. One bowl, hold the tray tight. Yep, and two, let's go.
At last, dinner is served. The toughest nights of my cooking career.
what I want to say is he's very brave.
That was a nightmare. Struggled. Across the whole 3 hours. I'd like to think I'd done it justice, but I left myself a little bit short, to be honest.
But my ordeal isn't over yet. I need to face my mentors to find out if I've impressed them.
How are you? Didn't recognise you with no hat on. How are the pig swatters?
I'm not a fan of that.
Damn, what a shame.
I think it's a little too much caramel sauce.
Really? Too sweet for you?
Yeah.
Wow.
I like the pig ear.
Oh, the pig's ear?
Yeah, beautiful texture. It's so crunchy. I love the texture.
Chewy, crunchy, crispy.
Yeah.
Soft and silky.
Got it.
The pork trotter, the pig trotter, is perfect. Pigs is the most difficult meat to cook. So it's really, really impressive what you have done with that.
The taste is too strong. And the color is too dark.
I think it's very difficult to do, very authentic. I think this one, I can eat this one, no problem.
Madam Doug, look at you.
Finally. I want to know what the doyen of nose-to-tail cooking thinks of my efforts.
Oh, my goodness me, what happened? Ah, that's amazing.
Voy.
Voy, voy.
We're happy, see, happy, very pleased.
She liked the best, the grill shoulder on skewers.
On the charcoal?
On the charcoal.
Well, if it wasn't for you, this shoulder wouldn't have tasted as good as it did. Trust me. I'm so glad that you like that one. Good to see you, Mr. Rice, as always.
Yeah. Some Vietnamese people is very hard to please. So, but tonight, Gordon, I think he does well. He passed it.
For me, one of the most thrilling 7 days I've ever spent in my cooking career. Honestly, if you want to eat well, get rid of your fridge. It forces you to buy ingredients twice a day and cook in a completely different way. Challenging week, yet for me, one of the most inspirational, big time. Crispy, crunchy, chewy, soft and silky. Right, airport. No macaroni, no fish and chips. We're in Malaysia, for God's sake.
You try your best not to get angry.
Mine's gone overcooked.
Is the part of the cow?
A bull's penis.
This is my clitoria bush.
Oh, gee. Come on, the Prime Minister's waiting for you. I miss an absolute pleasure.
The boat's filling up with water.